Hi and welcome to this video. It's February, the month of love. And much as I don't like some of the hype and commercialization that goes around Valentine's, I think it's still a good idea to have that one month where we focus on our relationships and we look at what we can improve, anything we need to do more of, anything we need to remove, and just give that focus in the month of February. So I'm going to also focus my videos this month on talking about different aspects of relationships. And this very first video is on how to catch a good spouse. Whether it be a wife or a husband, I think the five tips that I'm going to give will help you if you're not married. If you're married, of course, stay put, watch this video and give more suggestions so that we can help those who are looking what worked for you. Because what I'm going to share is more of what worked for me and what I've seen working for other people that have been married in the recent years that I know. So let's get down to that. And the first thing I would say is be ready. Be ready yourself. Prepare yourself. Are you actually ready to be married? Or are you still seeking yourself, looking for ways to grow yourself? You know, you're still on a me platform. Because if you're looking for a lifetime spouse to be married, then you need to be ready. You need to be ready to listen to someone else, to listen to their aspirations, their dreams, and also to be able to share your own, to be willing to be known that these are what my aspirations, these are my dreams, these are my fears. You know, that means you are vulnerable, you're open to being vulnerable. So if you're not at that point and you're still insecure and don't want to be known, then maybe you're not ready. And I would say if you're not ready, then yes, you can have friends, you can have fun, but don't lock people's hearts, knowing very well that you're not ready for the next step. So let them free, because when you waste their time, I don't think it's fair. And going around playing with other people's hearts really is not fair. So wait till you're ready. You may be beautiful and good looking, I agree, and that attracts people to you, but make sure that they know clearly, or you don't give any hints that may give them hope of a lifetime commitment. Okay, so that's step number one, personal readiness. The second step, or the second tip I would give, is to have a list of the things that you want to have in a great spouse. What would you consider a great spouse? Of course, I don't mean you have that strict list, you know, highlighted and sealed. No, because no one is perfect, and you're never going to find a perfect Mr. Right or a perfect Miss Right. So, but there are indicators, a few things that you think if they're missing in your wife or in your husband, you'll feel a bit shortchanged for life. So it could be just one thing or two things, I wouldn't say more than three, that you say these are critical for me, they really matter, and if they're not there, I may not be able to really enjoy my life with the person. Okay, so most of these are values, not just points of good looks or intelligence or certificates. No, these are usually issues to do with values. So once you pin down those values, then for sure the law of attraction, nature will bring to you the kind of people and the kind of situations where you'll find those qualities. So use that. If you don't know what you want, then it's like they say, anything goes. Any road can take you anywhere if you don't know where you're going. So if you have a few pointers, then it's easy to pick the route, the events that would help you find that kind of a person. So do that. And the third tip I would give is make yourself findable. Even a gadget with Bluetooth needs to find the other one, otherwise it can't communicate. So imagine if you're looking for a lifelong spouse, then they won't find you in a hole deep down hidden there. No, they'll have to find you somewhere. And that somewhere could be in a work event. So take part in some things. When there's a work event, don't just look at it as, oh, they have put me to work on a Saturday or on an evening. No, sometimes that's the platform that will get you that person that you're looking for. Or it could be that you volunteer in different things. I know church is a common place, but it's not the only one. So volunteer in other places where your services could be needed. Or play a sport or watch one. But going to sports events can be also a good platform. And well, those kind of things. And if you have been doing the same thing over the last 100 years and you haven't met the right person, I would say change it, change your route. If you usually drive, maybe you park your car for a few weeks and take public transport. Maybe that's where they are. Or if you go to the same church, you go to the same everything, you walk around the same block, you go to the same gym, maybe it's time to change. If you haven't met the person there so far, then they're not maybe going to show up. So change and get yourself a new routine that could give you higher chances. So that's about being visible, being findable. The only thing about going to those events is I would say, take yourself with you. Take yourself with you, and I really mean that, because sometimes we leave ourselves behind, and I don't know who goes to those parties, including weddings and that kind of thing. Take yourself with you. And what I mean is, be yourself. Don't go there acting as someone else, because the person you'll attract will be attracted to what you're portraying. And if it's not the real you, then you'll attract the wrong person. And imagine if you go on and on with that relationship based on a falsehood, it's not going to lead to anything good. So be yourself. Here's the best form of yourself, but yourself all the same. So that's what I would say. The other thing I would also say is learn to make good conversations. So when you go to those events, networking events or whatever other events, be sure that you have content for conversations so that you don't talk about yourself. You don't let the conversation focus about yourself, me, right? So let it be on a common topic that's of interest to people, usually not an antagonizing topic. Learn to listen to others, their point of view, and from there you get to converse properly. So that's all about being visible, but being visible as yourself, not as a fake, and being able to make good conversations. Then tip number 4 is focus on the heart. Have a heart-to-heart connection. By the time you've gone out with the person, you know, 2-3 times, get to connect with the heart, because the heart is where real emotions are, it's where thoughts are, it's where opinions are. So you need that heart-to-heart connection rather than a physical connection. So much as the physical part is plays a role when you're first attracted to someone, you know, you see the person and you feel, wow, that's somebody I like, also that's somebody I would want to know more. But don't let that be now the lead that takes you on and on. And getting into physical intimacy is a no-no, because what happens is it clouds your emotions, it clouds your everything. You're not able to actually see the situation for what it is. You can't even get to really know the person. So choose activities that will put you out there, make you have fun. Yes, you will have fun, but you'll also be able to talk, you'll be able to play, you'll be able to make a connection that is deeper than just a physical connection. So watching a movie, for example, every time you're on a date, you're watching a movie, I think the best you'll get is to know the characters of the movie very well. So you'll get to know all the top actors, but you will know the person who is taking you for those dates. So again, it's not a good thing that you just sit watching movies and never really getting to know each other. So coffee dates, walks in the park, they may sound old-fashioned, but believe you me, first of all, they can be very enjoyable once you get over that hangover of thinking they are shady. Once you get over that, you actually find you can really enjoy some of those outdoor activities. So get down to those so that you're able to really know each other and connect to the heart. Because the heart-to-heart connection is the one that can last a lifetime, not anything else. And lastly, the last tip I would want to give is not to shut out your family and friends. It happens that you fall in love and you swept off and you forget all your friends, you forget all your family. I don't think it's a good idea. I think once you realize that the relationship is moving to somewhere, then introduce the person to your friends, have shared activities with your friends and some of your family members, as you are the ones you're more comfortable with in the beginning. It's true, not all their opinions are valid. So some may have biases that you don't want to listen to, that they don't like this kind of complexions or this race or this tribe or this career or whatever. So some are not really valid comments, so you may choose to ignore those. But like they say, if someone says you look like a camel, you can ignore it. But if two people who are not even next to each other tell you you look like a camel, I think it's time you looked in the mirror. Yeah. So if a friend of yours says, oh, I think she has the tendency to be pushy and, you know, she seems to just know how to twist your emotions, you can ignore it. But if another person tells you, have you noticed that she tends to just twist you around her finger and to, then I would say start looking, start opening your eyes to that. Yeah. Or they say, you know, he's very overbearing. It's like everything has to go his way, or he loses his temper quite a bit. And you can ignore the first person, but if somebody else who interacts with him says the same thing, then you might want to think, is this something I want to live with? Is this something that I have been ignoring that I ought not to ignore? So don't shut out your friends, and find what kind of opinions they have, and they have usually the best of intentions. So unless their comments are really way out there and they don't make sense, I would say take note. Okay, so those are my 5 tips, and those of you who are watching and are married, add on some. How did it work for you? Especially if you're recently married, you may have some ideas that you can put on the comments. And if you're not subscribed to this channel, please do. It's all about love. We care for each other, so we share ideas. Thanks for watching.